So welcome again to this particular session. In the last one, we have had a discussion with respect to wholesale branch system. And I think 4.1 and 2 we have already done. And we had a discussion with respect to 4.3 actually, if you remember. And I had asked you to give a try to it. I do not know actually how many among you have really tried it out. But let's have a look. Head office sends goods to branch at 20% less than the list price. So head office is sending the goods this time at 20% less than the list price. This is your 4.3, correct? Which is cost plus 100%. Which is cost plus 100%. That means your cost price, if we presume to be as 100, and if I am going to add 100% to it, obviously your list price will be equal to 200. List price will be equal to 200. And goods are being sent at 20% less than the list price. That means wholesale price or invoice price is equal to 160. So three rates we come across. One is cost price, which is equal to 100. Another one is your wholesale price, and wholesale price is equal to 160. And finally, we have in this case list price, which is equal to 200. If I take the difference between the 100 and 160, that will be equal to 60 by 160 or 3 by 8. Because in the denominator we have wholesale price, I need not require to tell you that this rate can be applied on an item which is at wholesale price, and that item will slide back to cost price, correct? Similarly, if we take the difference between the wholesale price and list price, that comes to 40. 40 by 200 or 1 by 5. Because in the denominator we have list price, so obviously this rate can be applied on an item which is at list price. The item will come back to invoice price, correct? Besides, in this particular case, we have another rate. We have another rate. If we compare cost price and list price, the difference between cost price and list price is 100. 100 by 200 or 1 by 2. Because in the denominator there is list price, so this rate can be applied only on list price. But point is that this time if I am going to apply this rate, that item will fall back from list price to cost price. So first thing is that you need to be very deft as far as analysis of rates is concerned. Then as I told you, under the second step, in the books of head office, you are going to prepare in the books of head office. In the books of head office, you are going to prepare head office trading and profit and loss account. Head office trading and profit and loss account. So this is the point which you have to understand. In order to prepare this account, I think this much is enough. Okay. So now we can start the question. Opening stock, there is no opening stock with the head office or branch office at this particular moment. So we start with purchases. This is your head office trading and profit and loss account, as I told you. Head office trading and profit and loss account. We will write here purchases because no opening stock in this particular question. Purchases is 2 lakhs. Just give me a second. This is head office trading and profit and loss account. So purchases are 2 lakh, then goods sent to branch is equal to 80,000. So towards the opposite side, I will write here goods sent to branch account. I have already explained that head office will always send the goods to the branch at wholesale price. No doubt about that, these goods are at wholesale price. But from the perspective of the head office, these goods have been sold out. Correct? So that is the reason we need not require to extract any loading of this particular item. So we shall write 80,000. Because head office has sent these goods to branch, quite obviously head office will be under the impression that all these goods would be sold out. Then head office has sold the goods to the customer, but this time at list price. Generally, head office sells the goods to the customer at wholesale price, but in this question, it is clearly mentioned list price. So I will write here sales, and amount of sales is at list price, and list price is 1,70,000. Again, I need not require to take loading portion because these are actual sales. So both these items are basically sales. So that is the reason we need not require to do anything. In this particular question, expenses have been given. Expenses will be debited to profit and loss account. So I will write expenses in the profit and loss account. That is 20,000. Correct? Now, the first thing is that we have to find out the closing stock. So closing stock with head office. In order to find out closing stock with head office, if you remember, we had a lot of discussion regarding that in the last session, isn't it or not? So in order to find out closing stock . First of all, I will write opening stock. Now, there is no opening stock with head office in this particular question. Then we will add purchases. No opening stock and purchases are worth rupees 2 lakhs. So that means cost of goods available. This is cost of the goods which are available with the head office. Cost of the goods available with head office. That is 2 lakhs. Now, we know that out of 2 lakhs, some of the goods have been sent to the branch. So, I will subtract here and I will write here cost of goods, cost of goods A, sent to branch, cost of goods sent to branch office. Now we have been given in the question that head office has sent 80,000 worth of goods at wholesale price. 80,000 worth of goods at wholesale price. So I have to find out its what we call cost price. So in order to find out the cost of the goods which have been sent by head office to branch office, this is 80,000, which is at wholesale price. I want to convert wholesale price to cost price. So that is why I will have to apply the rate of 3/8. That will be equal to 30,000. So we can say that 50,000 worth of goods, which were having a cost of 50,000, were sent to branch at 80,000. So important point is that we have been able to find out that out of 2 lakh goods which were available with the head office at cost, 50,000 worth of goods costing have been sent out to the branch, of course, at wholesale price of 80,000. Similarly, cost of sales. Head office has done sales also in this question. And sales done by head office is equal to 1,70,000. And this is at list price. You have to understand this. Because this time sales done by head office is at list price and my target is to know the cost price. That means I want to bring the list price to cost price. So I will look into the rate, because I am talking about list price and cost price. I want to bring list price to cost price. So I will have to take this particular rate, which is 1/2. Because if I am going to apply this rate, the item will come back to cost price. So I will write here 1/2. So it will be equal to 85,000. So as you can see that goods costing 85,000 were sold by head office at list price of 1,70,000. So out of 2,00,000, we can say 50,000 worth of goods have been sent, 85,000 worth of goods have been sold. So closing stock will be equal to 2,00,000 minus 1,35,000. So that will be equal to 65,000. So 65,000 is the closing stock. This should be your first target. So 65,000 worth of stock you have been able to find out. So closing stock. Through your working note, you have been able to find out it is 65,000. Now we will take the difference. And if we will take the difference, we will find out the profit. Correct? We will find out the profit. So profit in this particular question is 1,15,000. 1,15,000 is your gross profit. Actually, this gross profit, I have already told you, is nothing but the margin. For example, if you will look very carefully, the goods which you sent to branch were having a wholesale price of 80,000 and their cost was 50,000. So margin was 30,000. So logically, this gross profit comprises of margin on goods sent, which is 30,000. And similarly, sales have been done by head office at 1,70,000, but their cost was 85. So margin was 85. Now, if you will add these two, it will be equal to 1,15,000. You need not require to show it in this manner in the examination. You simply take it as balancing figure. Now, gross profit brought down. Gross profit brought down is equal to 1,15,000. Now the point here is that out of this gross profit, 30,000 worth of profit cannot be termed as realized. However, 85,000 worth of margin or profit can be easily termed as realized, because this is the margin on goods sold. So the actual sales have taken place, so this profit has already realized. However, we are not sure about what we call this profit, because we do not have any confirmation right now whether the branch has been able to sold out all the goods or not. So now we have to find out closing stock with the branch, whether there is any or not. This is your second step. Second working. Closing stock. With branch. In order to find out closing stock with branch, what you have to do, in one column you write wholesale price, in one column you write sales. First you write here goods sent to branch. You have sent this year goods to the branch at a wholesale price of 80,000. Correct? You sold the goods to the branch having a wholesale price of 80,000. Now we will look into what are actual sales of the branch. In order to know the actual sales of the branch, we will have to look into the question, and actual sales of the branch is 80,000. Branch will always sell the goods at list price, as we know. So sales is equal to 80,000, no doubt about it. So for a moment, it appears to us that we have sent 80,000 worth of goods and 80,000 worth of sales is there. So there is no question of any closing stock with the branch. But that's not true, in fact. If you look carefully, these sales are at list price. So I have to find out the wholesale price of these goods. How can I find the wholesale price of these goods? See here, list price is 80,000. What is your intention? First, you ask yourself, you want to convert list price, because this is at list price, you want to convert it into wholesale price. So you look into your table, you want to convert list price to wholesale price. So this is the rate you will have to use, 1/5. Is it clear to you or not? In order to convert list price into wholesale price, I write here 1/5. 1/5 is equal to 16,000. So you can see that if I will subtract 16,000 from 80,000, I will be left up with 64,000. What is this 64,000? This is the wholesale price of the goods sold. That means branch has sold out of 80,000, 64,000 worth of wholesale priced goods at rupees 80,000. Important thing is that now we have been able to find out that out of 84,000, branch has sold out 64,000 worth of goods, and branch has sold 64,000 worth of goods at 80,000. But important point is that closing stock with the branch is 16,000. That means 16,000 worth of goods have remained unsold. So quite obviously, whatever profit is there in the 16,000 worth of goods is not realized. So that profit will be debited to the profit and loss account. And here I am going to write unrealized profit. The unrealized profit will be equal to 3/8 into 16,000. 16,000 is the remaining stock with the branch. 16,000 that is 2 into 3, it is equal to 6,000. So now we can easily get net profit in this particular question. That will be our net profit. So our net profit will be equal to 1,15,000 minus 20,000 minus 6,000, that is equal to 89,000. Is it clear to you? That is how we will solve this particular question. Further, you may be asked to prepare what we call branch office trading and profit and loss account. Branch office trading and profit and loss account. In order to prepare the branch office trading and profit and loss account, what you have to do, you prepare first of all account like this. Now, first of all, the goods which have been sent by head office will be received by the branch. So goods sent to branch account will be returned towards the debit side. 80,000 worth of goods having wholesale price were sent to branch. Remember one thing. Trading and profit and loss account is always prepared at cost, but wholesale price is nothing but cost for the branch, correct? Because branch will receive the goods at this price, so it is cost for branch. Now, branch has done sales. Of course, branch has done sales at list price. And amount of sales is equal to 80,000. And we have also computed the closing stock. Closing stock as per working note was 16,000 with the branch. That is equal to 16,000 with the branch, correct? So we can say that gross profit is equal to 16,000. Gross profit is equal to 16,000. This is the gross profit earned by branch, we may say. Now gross profit will be written in the lower portion, 16,000. Now in this question, there are some expenses of branch also. Expenses of the branch, if you will look into the question, expenses of the branch were 10,000, correct? Expenses of the branch were 10,000. So you will debit 10,000 and total profit earned by branch, total net profit earned by branch will be equal to 6,000. Net profit will be equal to 6,000. This is how the branch is going to actually prepare the profit and loss account in this particular case. Is it clear to you or not? So hope you have understood this one. If some of you might have given it a try, fine. And now we move over to 4.4. What does 4.4 states? Beta Limited, having a head office at Mumbai, has a branch at Nagpur. Head office is in Mumbai and branch is at Nagpur. The head office does wholesale trade only. The head office does wholesale trade only means head office sells the goods to the customer at wholesale price. Head office does wholesale trade only at cost plus 80%. That means if cost is 100, 80% means 80, so 180 is your wholesale price. The goods are sent to the branch at wholesale price, namely. So goods are sent to branch at wholesale price, which is 180. That is cost plus 80%. The branch at Nagpur is wholly engaged in retail trade. Branch at Nagpur is wholly engaged in retail trade means it sells the goods on retail basis. That is at what we call cost plus 100%. That means your list price again is 200. So first of all, in this question, I will have to frame the rate. 4.4 is the question. So I will use this format once again. Just give me a bit of time. Just wait. Okay. So now we come back to this. In this question, cost is 100, but wholesale price is actually 180, as we have just seen, isn't it or not? So I'm talking about, first of all, 4.4. 4.4 is the question we are picking up. Wholesale price we have seen actually is 180. And list price is 200. Once you have figured out what is your cost price, what is your wholesale price, and what is your list price, then we come back to framing of rates. As far as framing of rates is concerned, in this particular case, when you will frame the rates, it will be equal to 80 difference between cost and wholesale price divided by 180. That is equal to 4/9. Of course, this rate can be applied on an item which is at wholesale price. And if you will apply this rate, then it will turn back to cost price. Correct? Now, we take the difference between wholesale price and list price, which is 20, 20/200. That is 1/10. If I am going to apply this rate on an item which is at list price, that will fall back to invoice price. Third rate, similar to the last question. Difference between cost price and list price is 100, 1/2. If I am going to apply this rate to an item which is at list price, it will fall back to cost price. Once you are done up with the rates, now the next point is to look into the table. When I will look into the table in this particular question, just wait. Actually, I want to avoid framing of accounts. What happened? Okay, first furnish the information. As far as information is concerned in this particular question, 4.4, you have opening stock 2,25,000 and purchases are 25,50,000. Opening stock 2,25,000. So first you are going to write here opening stock, which is 2,25,000. 2,25,000 is your opening stock. Then you are going to write your purchases. If you are going to write your purchases, in this particular case, the purchases amount is 25,50,000. 25,50,000. 25,50,000. Then we have goods sent to branch at cost. At cost to head office, cost to head office is 100 plus 80%. That means at wholesale price, goods have been sent 9,54,000. So goods sent to branch 9,54,000. I am going to write here 9,54,000. Now in this particular question, we have been given sales by the head office 27,81,000. Sales by head office is 27,81,000. However, these sales are at wholesale price in this particular question, because it was clearly mentioned that head office does only wholesale trade. So these sales are at wholesale price 27,81,000. Correct. Now we have been given office expenses, selling expenses and staff salary. I will add all these expenses. Correct. 90 plus 72 plus 65. So total is equal to 2,27,000. Total of these expenses is equal to 2,27,000. So I will debit these expenses to the P&L account, 2,27,000. Then we have been given, later on I will need to add these items. Let me add this at this moment. 8,500, 6,300 plus 12, plus 12,000. That is equal to 26,800. So as to avoid cumbersome later on. So everything has been furnished now. We have to find out closing stock with the head office. In order to find out closing stock with the head office, first of all, let me rub it out. Okay then. First of all, we will see and look into the closing, into the opening stock. Now, opening stock is 2,25,000. So I will write opening stock 2,25,000. Opening stock is 2,25,000. Amount of purchases is 25,50,000. So I will write here 25,50,000. Forgotten the figure. Figures are pretty cumbersome. 25,50,000. 25,50,000. So we may say that total goods, 27,75,000 worth of cost are available with the head office. Correct. 27,75,000 worth of goods are available with the head office. Now, cost of goods sent to branch. Now we will look over the fact that head office in the current year has sent 9,54,000 worth of goods to branch. This is the wholesale price of the goods, 9,54,000. Because this is the wholesale price, you will have to convert it back to your cost price. Now look into the table. In order to convert wholesale price into cost price, you will need a rate of 4/9. So you apply 4/9 to it. If you apply 4/9, it will be equal to 9,54,000 into 4 divided by 9, that is 4,24,000. So the goods which we send to branch is having a margin of 4,24,000. If I deduct this figure from 9,54,000, that means cost of the goods which we sent is actually 5,30,000. Cost of the goods which have been sent is 5,30,000. Similarly, sales incurred by head office in this particular case is 27,81,000. So 27,81,000, this is the amount of sales. In this question, head office has also sold the goods on wholesale price. So in order to know the cost price, I will have to again apply the rate 4/9. 27,81,000 into 4 divided by 9 is equal to 12,36,000. 12,36,000. I will have to subtract it from 27,81,000. So 15,45,000 is the cost of the goods sold. The goods sold by head office at wholesale price is this much, but their cost is 15,45,000. So now we can find out the amount of closing stock. We had 27,25,000, 27,75 minus 530 and minus 15,45. So 7 lakh worth of closing stock is remaining with the head office. This is your first target, correct? Once you have found out closing stock, which is 7 lakh, now you are in a position to find out your gross profit. So many times I have told you, your gross profit basically is nothing but the margins on goods sent to branch. Now, margin on goods sent to branch account is 4,24,000. So you are going to write here 424. And plus margin on cost of sales. Margin on sales is 12,36,000. So 12,36,000. If I will add both these amount, it will be equal to the balancing figure which I would get. 424 plus 1236 is equal to 16,60,000. Even if you are going to balance, you will get 16,60,000 as your gross profit. Correct? Once you have found out the gross profit, now you will have to bring it down. 16,60,000. 4,24,000 worth of profit cannot be termed as realized, but 12,36,000 worth of profit that is related to actual sales is realized profit. Problem is with respect to this profit. So, answer will be given when we will come to know what is the closing stock with the branch now. In order to find out the closing stock with the branch, similar to the last one, first of all, what I will have to do, I will have to find out that in the current year, head office has sent 9,54,000 worth of goods at wholesale price to the branch. Now I will look into the column of the branch, and branch has done a sale of 9,50,000. Total sales by branch is equal to 9,50,000. Clear? So because branch has made actual sales of 9,50,000, and we are well aware that branch sells the goods at list price. So we want to know the wholesale price of this item, and this item is at list price. So list price is 9,50,000, and I want to know the wholesale price. In order to know the wholesale price, again I will look into my rates. I want to know the wholesale price of list price item. So that is why I will have to apply the rate 1/10 in this particular case. So I will write here 1/10. If I will apply 1/10, it will be equal to 95,000. If I subtract from 950, 95, I will get 8,55,000. This 8,55,000 is nothing but the wholesale price of the goods sold. That means branch has sold out 8,55,000 worth of goods at 950. Importantly, you have been able to find out what amount of goods branch has sold out of total amount of goods sent. So out of total 9,54,000 worth of goods, branch has sold out 8,55,000 worth of goods, so the remaining stock will be equal to 954 minus 855, that is equal to 99,000. So 99,000 worth of stock is still with the branch. That means out of 9,54,000, 99,000 worth of stock could not be sold out by branch. So we will compute unrealized profit on this particular item. So 99,000, this is at wholesale price, and we want to bring it to the what we call cost price. So in this question, in order to bring wholesale price to cost price, we will have to apply the rate of 4 by 9. So that will be equal to 44,000. And your net profit will be equal to 16,60,000 minus 227 minus 44, that is 13,89,000. 13,89,000 will be your net profit. Is it clear to you or not? Very, very important question, all these are. Now, if you want to prepare branch trading and profit and loss account, I have already told you it's a mere formality, hardly asked. But in case if it is asked, you should be in a position to deliver the answer. As far as branch is concerned, you have sent 9,54,000 worth of goods to branch, so you will write 9,54,000 first of all here. Then actual sales which branch did is equal to 9,50,000. And you have been able to find out the closing stock with the branch, which is equal to 99,000. 99,000. Your gross profit will be equal to 95,000. If you will take the balancing figure, reason being is that because gross profit is nothing. See, branch has sold out 8,55,000 worth of goods. Branch has sold out 8,55,000 worth of goods at 950. So the difference 95,000 is nothing but gross profit is straight away you can write. So 95,000 is your gross profit. Total expenses of the branch which we computed equal to 26,800. So now we will get the net profit made by the branch. 95,000 minus 26,800. So branch will be under an impression that it has made a profit of 68,200. So that is how we are able to hide the real profit, because real profit, as you can see, is much higher. Anyway, so this is your 4.4. And after 4.4, there is another question. And even this question you should be in a position to do. I will explain it. G9 Limited having a head office at Delhi, correct? And has a branch at Citywide. The head office does wholesale trade. Similar to the last question, head office does wholesale trade only at cost plus 80%. At cost plus 80%. So similar to the last question, even in this question, 4.4, if I will pick up 4.4, your cost price is 100 and your wholesale price is cost plus 80%, that is equal to 180. And similar to the last question, goods are sent to the branch at wholesale price only, that is 180. The branch is wholly engaged in retail trade and goods are sold at cost plus 100%. Your list price will be equal to 200. So if you will take the difference 80 by 180, 4 by 9, below is wholesale price. So your wholesale price will fall back to cost price. Similarly, if you take the difference between wholesale price and list price, that is equal to 20. 20 by 200, 1 by 10. Below is list price. You can apply this item to an item which is at list price, and that item will fall back to wholesale price. And these are the vital things. And again, if you want to compute, you can take the difference between the cost price and the list price. That is equal to 100 by 200 or 1 by 2. Obviously, this rate can be applied on an item which is at list price, and list price will fall back to cost price. These are your rates as far as this particular question is concerned. Now, as far as opening stock is concerned, head office trading and profit and loss account, first of all, you will write head office trading and profit and loss account. On the debit side of head office trading and profit and loss account, you will write opening stock. Opening stock is 1,25,000. Then we have purchases, 21,50,000. You will write here purchases. Amount of purchases is 21,50,000. Then you have goods sent to branch. Goods sent to branch, it is a sort of sales for you. Of course, you are sending the goods to the branch at wholesale price. And from your perspective, that is from the perspective of the head office, these are considered as sales. 7,38,000. Then actual sales by head office. Remember, in this question, head office does wholesale trade only. It means sales done by head office will be at wholesale price, 23,79,600. Then you have office expenses, selling expenses, and staff salary, similar to the last one. You add all these expenses, it will be equal to 50 plus 32 plus 45, that is equal to 1,27,000. You write it somewhere here, 1,27,000. Correct. Now the point here is that we have to find out closing stock. In order to find out closing stock, we need to do some working. And you are now quite efficient in doing that particular working. So we will do the working. In order to do the working, first of all, what you are supposed to write, you are supposed to write opening stock. Now, opening stock in this question with the head office is actually 1,25,000. So you will write here 1,25,000. Then purchases. Head office has purchased goods. Purchases is equal to 21,50,000. You will write 21,50,000. So we may say that total worth of goods available is equal to 22,75,000. 22,75,000. Correct? Out of that, I will have to subtract less cost of A, goods sent to branch. In the current year, head office has sent 7,38,000 worth of goods to the branch. 7,38,000. This is at wholesale price. I want to know the cost price. I look into the rate. In order to bring the wholesale price to the cost price, the rate is actually 4/9. So I will apply here 4/9. If I apply 4/9 to 7,38,000, it will be equal to how much? That is 3,28,000. 3,28,000. This is the margin, you can say, included in goods sent to branch account. So 4,10,000 is the cost of the goods sent to branch. This is the cost. Similarly, we will find the cost of sales. Now, head office in the current year has done sales to the extent of 23,79,600. 23,79,600. These sales are again are at wholesale price. We want to know the cost. So wholesale price must be brought back to cost price. 23,79,600 into 4 divided by 9 is equal to 10,057,600. This is the margin, you can see. If I subtract this from 2,379,600, I will be left off with 1,322,000. That means the cost of the sales is actually 1,322,000. That means head office has sold out goods costing 1,322,000 at 2,379,600. Now I will subtract both these amounts: 2,275,000 minus 4,10,000 minus 1,322,000. 5,43,000 is the closing stock. So 5,43,000 is the closing stock. I simply wanted to check actually. 5,43,000. So 5,43,000 is your closing stock. You have been able to find out closing stock. You simply now put it over here. 5,43,000. Gross profit. You can simply take it as balancing figure, or as I told you, it is nothing but margin. 3,28,000 margin on goods sent to branch account. 3,28,000 and 10,57,600. If you will add these two margin, it will be equal to your gross profit. Gross profit will be equal to 3,28,000 plus 10,57,600. That is equal to 13,85,600, correct? You take this gross profit now to the credit of your profit and loss account. 13,85,600. We have already written expenses here. Now we need to find out unrealized profit, URP. In order to know the URP or unrealized profit, we need to know about the situation with the branch. So again, a working will be done. We have to find out closing stock with the branch. Closing stock with the branch. In order to compute closing stock with the branch, just two columns, wholesale price and list price, you need to frame. Then you simply write here goods sent to branch. You have in the current year sent goods having wholesale price of 7,38,000. Now we will look into the column of the branch. And we find that branch has done sales to the extent of 7,30,000. So, sales by branch is equal to 7,30,000. Now, I want to know, because I know that these are at list price, I want to know the wholesale price. So, list price is equal to 7,30,000. I want to convert list price to wholesale price. Wholesale price is 180, list price is actually 200. The difference was 20 by 200, 1 by 10. So I will have to apply a rate of 1 by 10 to bring it to wholesale price. 1 by 10 is equal to 73,000. So if I will subtract 73 from 7,30,000, I will get 6,57,000. 6,57,000 is your closing stock with the branch. That means whatever goods you sent to branch, that is 7,38,000, out of these, 6,57,000 worth of goods have been sold out by branch at 7:30. Now we will take the difference of these two, 7,38 minus 6,57. So 81,000 is closing stock with the branch. That means whatever goods you send to branch, branch failed to sell 81,000 worth of those goods. So that is why you will write here unrealized profit, that is 81,000 into 4 by 9 because these goods are at wholesale price now. So into 4 by 9. 81,000 into 4 divided by 9 is equal to 36,000. So 36,000 is your unrealized profit. And now you can find out your net profit also. 1385,600 minus 127,000 minus 36,000. So your net profit is equal to 1,222,600. This is how you are going to compute the net profit in this particular question. At least take the trouble of preparing branch trading and profit and loss account. When you will prepare the branch trading and profit and loss account, on the debit side you will write goods sent to branch 7,38,000. On the credit side you will write the actual sales 7,30,000. And of course, your gross profit will be 73,000. Closing stock, you have already computed 81,000, correct? And then you simply debit the expenses of the branch, and then you can easily find out the profit. So with that, we have completed this particular section also. In the next section, we'll talk about independent branches. So far, what we have done was related to dependent branches. So now we'll move over to independent branches. Name itself is suggesting that these are independent branches. So unlike the dependent branches, these branches are not fully dependent upon the head office. They will have the right to make purchases of their own. In fact, we will see that they prepare their own accounts. They will keep track of their what we call own accounts. Finally, they will what we call prepare their trial balance. And after having prepared the trial balance, these branches, independent branches, will send it back to head office. So what we are supposed to do under independent branches, of course, that will be discussed in the next session. So till then, it's time to say goodbye.